Hi everybody and happy Friday. And if you've had midterm this week, I hope it went really well. It's lashing rain out there today and we've had a really bad week weather-wise. We've even had storm Dars, but despite that, I have to say we've actually had a great midterm. We got out an awful lot. We got to do an awful lot of things. So to celebrate, we have something new here. We're going to have a little video for you. We're calling it Take Five. Okay, so maybe push pause, go make yourself a cup of tea or a hot cocoa and come back and sit for 5 minutes and watch a little video. We want to share some information with you. Okay, and today we're going to talk about how snails make their shells. Okay, see you in five. Okay, hi everybody. Today I am going to do a little video blog instead of a written blog for a few reasons. One being that I have a house full of kids on midterm break, so the writing bit just isn't happening today. And another is because I am joined by a very, very important scientist who wants to help me out. So, are you going to come and help out?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So here he is. This is Rowan.
Okay. Hello, I'm Rowan.
Okay, so yesterday, Rowan, you asked me a question about snails. Do you remember what the question was?
Yes. How do snails get their shells?
How do snails get their shells? It's a very good question, isn't it?
Yeah.
And have we learned anything?
Yes.
Do you want to tell us?
Well, they're born with their shells, which is actually very, very delicate and see-through.
Very good. So they're born with the shells, aren't they?
Yeah.
And as you said, it's very delicate, it's see-through, and it's quite soft, isn't it? It's not the hard shell that we're used to.
But if, like, you poke
Stay
it...
Stay in the video so they can
If
see.
You poke it, then it'll just, like, fog down.
It could do.
Yeah.
Okay, and how does it get stronger?
They eat their eggs that they came out of, and they eat sand and... mud.
Very good. They have to get something that's in our bones and in our teeth that make our bones and teeth strong too. Do you remember what it's called?
Calcium.
Calcium, very good. So they need to eat calcium in order to make the shells get harder and stronger and to grow. So you told us there a minute ago where did they get the first bit of calcium? What did you tell us they eat?
From their shell.
From their egg, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah.
From the egg that they hatch out of. And then what do they often eat to get it as they're growing?
Sand and...
soil or dirt, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so as they grow, the shell gets harder and bigger and it goes in a spiral, isn't it? And the middle bit of the spiral is where that very soft early shell ends up, okay? But it's hard then. Okay, so that's a bit that we learned about their shells, okay?
Yeah.
But we have some other interesting things that we've learned about the slime that they make.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to tell us anything about that?
Okay, well, they have this big fur and it moves like a muscle. And whenever they... I forget it, I don't know.
Yeah, they have a big foot and it moves like a muscle along like this, don't they?
Yeah, and the slime is used for not getting hurt, but like, say if one was on a nail, say, the slime won't get, slime would make them not
hurt. It protects them from, say, harsh things like that might cut them, doesn't it? Yeah. And bacteria as well.
Mm-hmm.
And from sunlight, so they don't get burnt. Do you know that bit? And there's some really interesting things about slime as well, okay? The ancient Greeks used to use it on their face and their skin. Did you know that? They used to put them on their face. Should I do that?
Heck no.
No, I don't think so. But snail slime and different components from it can be found in certain cosmetics, that, you know, creams and things that we put on our faces.
Yeah.
Imagine that. Because some believe that increases our youthfulness, it can remove wrinkles, it can make the face heal a little bit more, and can give you a clearer, smoother skin, basically. Now, there is some science research has been done on this, okay, but they're still unsure. There's a lot more to be done. But they have shown that it may reduce swelling and inflammation, okay? So they have had some positive results with people who have burns and things like that, that snail slime can help. And what else? Do you want to say something?
Yes.
His hand went up there.
You could...
Get in the video so we can see.
You could put, like, say, a type of cream you put on you, and... If you find any snails or slugs, you could just like use their, you could try and take their slime and mix it with the cream stuff, and then you could use it for sun cream.
You could do, and some creams do that, but scientists still aren't sure if it really, really works very well yet. So there's still a lot more tests to do, but it is in some creams for the skin, so you're right. And they do think that it may reduce, make skin younger, reduce damage from the sun, like you said, or healing, to reduce inflammation. It's supposed to hydrate the skin. So we'll see. There's a lot more research. I won't be putting any snails on my face just yet. What else is it used for? There are a group of researchers who actually used slime. They made it like a synthetic slime. They were inspired by the slime of snails, and they used it to make a glue, a special type of glue to glue broken hearts together, basically, but not the romantic kind, not when somebody gets their heart broken in a relationship. Okay, so they've used it in heart treatment, but only on pig hearts for the moment. It's just little tests, but maybe one day they pig slime will be used, or something that was inspired by pig slime will be used to fix real hearts, human hearts one day. Had one other thing as well, some snails, because not all snails are on land, some are in the sea or in lakes and things like that, and there's some in the sea, for example, that produce, don't do that, thank you, that produce venom to kill that they inject in their prey to kind of paralyze them, right? And some people think that if they use that in their faces, that they'll be able to stop wrinkles. Can you imagine? It might be the new Botox, but I don't think I'd want to try it.
No.
Okay, will we say bye-bye to everybody?
Bye-bye.
Do you think they enjoyed our talk on snails? Did you enjoy learning something about them?
I don't know.
You don't know. Okay, say bye.
Bye. I don't like...